welcome to the SO exam.
Thank you, RC.
How are you?
I'm good, thank you.
So we're going to talk about your academic life as well as the professional career on this talk in next 30 to 45 minutes, roughly.
Luckily, I was quite good with the course, so I finished it in 2 years.
So it sounds like you are a very good student.
I was quite good at science back then. Into neuroscience, you know, it's like the bachelor's was more just the basics. Like it was, you know, deep, but it wasn't like how can I diverse myself into, because neuroscience is such a big field itself. Yeah. You know, there's so many different fields within neuroscience. Mm. So I thought I would go into neuroscience to understand which part of neuroscience I really want to study.
Right.
So yeah, I did my master's in neuroscience.
Was it fun or was it very stressful?
It was very stressful, yeah, because I was in the college at King's. There was quite a few doctors who had actually were medical doctors, but they wanted to do neuroscience as a master's because they just wanted to not do more clinical work and do some clinical research so they can do some papers.
Right.
So I managed to meet some really nice, interesting guys who were, you know, doing, they wanted to do clinical research.
So it's a very full-time, very busy.
Yeah, it was a very hectic,
year.
Yeah, yeah. Could do some research in UCL, which is quite good, near Great Portland Street. There was a lab there. So I worked there for like, you know, just under shadowing the, there were times when I was looking at Alzheimer's and then there were these proteins called the tau protein and back then there was amyloid plaques and, you know, there's always this, there's always the, back then, right, there used to be two kind of groups. One would only believe on tau proteins, one would only believe on beta amyloid plaques.
Right.
Because these are the conditions, you know, you see these, the how the degeneration of the protein happens.
So it's more like a process, two different process or principle.
Both symptoms, obviously.
You get pocket money.
Yeah, I get some money as well, which
that's
is quite good.
Yeah, to, you know, to celebrate on the weekends.
Yeah. And then after the, you know, once you've done your doctorate, then you decide, now what, you know?
Yeah.
So that was the challenging part. Whether to go do postgraduate, you know, more postdoctoral. I might come back to academic world in future, but for now I want to see what the corporate world is like. And because there's more opportunities there, you know,
right.
In terms of earning prospectus, prospect is good.
That's quite fascinating, isn't it?
Yeah.
Gene sequencing, next gen sequencing, so that's what they call, isn't it?
Yeah, so, you know, next generation sequencing, you can use it for personalized medicine. For genetic diseases, looking at diagnostics. So
is it very useful for a hospital?
Yes, it's useful for, you know.
I'm very much like, I don't really know this world.
Yeah.
So I just want to have like very,
so we look,
you know,
at, like, let's
basic
say like
understanding
this, there are
what is
called,
it.
So there are things like called CNV, which is copy number variants.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So copy number variants are things where you try and see if there's deletion or duplication of a particular
gene.
Yeah. So you see that. So CNVs can be detected, but you need a lot of software as well. So where we work, we also need a lot of computer scientists. You know, bioinformaticians who know how to run this software to do analyze all the data. So we work in hand to hand with those guys as well.
Right.
But the sequencing itself, like, you know, we are the, what we are doing now at the moment.
Go back to your country and live there, or you are happy sort of stay here in terms of like career thing, progress.
I mean, I would love to go to Nepal and do something there. You know, I mean, even now I'm even thinking like, you know, what I've done here, if I could transform and just take what I've learned here, take it to Nepal and do some kind of joint venture with people over there in Nepal, like, you know, the labs there, and talk to them and see, like, you know, if we can work together. And, you know, maybe my future dream would be to like have my own sequencing lab at some point.
I think that's all for today. Thank you very much for this. So any questions or if you want to ask anything to our expert from Izam, you always welcome to email us the.expert.talks@gmail.com or hello rcadhikari@gmail.com.